Hi, I'm Scott Noonan, CEO of Audio Advice. Today's video is on outdoor televisions. We've been in business for over 40 years, and as you might imagine, we've installed a heck of a lot of outdoor televisions. Everything from indoor televisions on a screen porch to really killer outdoor televisions that rain can rain on and everything else. So what I want you to do is really get the concept of how to think about how to choose an outdoor television. So, you know, maybe a couple of the model numbers will change over time, but if you watch this video, you'll really get a sense of, okay, this is how I need to approach it and what I need to think about. So let me start with this. There's some discussion people often have, which is, can I just buy a cheaper indoor television and put it out on the porch? So let's start there. And I'm gonna start with a screened porch. So you've got a screened porch on the back of the house, and the screened porch has got the screens to block out some of the bugs and things that could get into a television, but also it can block rain and sun from the television. If you have that situation, this is primarily the one situation where you could argue, hey, I'm gonna get a cheaper indoor television, put it on my screen porch, and you know what? It might die earlier than an outdoor television, but it's cheaper and I can buy a couple of these for the price of an outdoor television. So there are situations where that works and you can sort of think through it. The downsides are, one, obviously it won't last as long. Indoor televisions are not designed to get extremely cold or extremely hot. When they get dust in them, it causes problems over time. And you have to think about things like, is my mount outdoor made? In other words, can it handle the elements, et cetera? But there's a trade-off there, and you can make that decision. If you've got questions, feel free to give us a call at Audio Advice. We can help you think through, should I use indoor or not? One thing to be clear about, if you use an indoor television outdoors, as soon as you do that, you've lost the warranty. So, if I'm gonna do outdoor televisions and I decide I wanna do this right, put it on the outdoor porch, what should I do? Well, there's three major brands today that if we were recommending to someone, they pick one, it would be in these three brands. The first is Samsung. Samsung came out with a Terrace television, and it's a great television designed to sit on your porch. The main thing they did that separated from everyone else was they really got the brightness level up really high. So the nit level on the main Samsung Terrace is 2000 nits. And just give you a perspective, that's way higher than everyone else does, so it's bright. And I can tell you, no one ever has an outdoor television and wishes it weren't super bright. The other thing that Samsung has done, it actually has an IP55 rating. And what that means is the two numbers, the first five relates to how much it protects from dust coming in, which is very good at a five, and how much it protects from water, which is also a five for the 55. And the Samsung can actually protect from water hitting it and even a little bit of spray getting on it, so you don't have to worry about it being outside. However, it cannot go in direct sunlight. So this is why it's a great solution to be on the screened in porch, because you don't have direct sunlight on it. And then that makes it a terrific solution. The other thing that's great about the Samsung Terrace is that it's got all the Samsung apps built into it, meaning YouTube, YouTube TV, Hulu, you name it, all your major apps, which means you don't need to run a cable feed from your house into the television. If you've got great Wi-Fi, you can connect to the Wi-Fi and actually watch all your apps, meaning you just need the electrical on the porch to get to it, which is a great solution. Okay, so let's move from that to Sunbrite, which is the second big television manufacturer in the space. Sunbrite offers a 55, a 65, 75. It actually has a 43-inch as well, whereas the Terrace solutions are 55, 65, and 75. So you can get a little bit smaller one as well with Sunbrite. Sunbrite calls theirs the Verdana Series, and that's the series that would go onto the porch, meaning it doesn't have direct sunlight and it's protected from the rain, but it's still outside, so it can handle dust, etc. That one is not as bright as the Samsung, but it's a little bit less expensive. And then the third major brand in the space is called Seura. They've been in the business for a long time, and they specialize in high-end outdoor televisions. Their television that would sit out on your porch, which is called the Shade Series, is about 700 nits, so it's, you know, it's quite a bit less than Samsung, but it's also a less expensive product. All of these also have fully weatherproof remotes. So when you think about, oh, I'm just gonna put an indoor television outside, you gotta think through the details of, okay, well then I sort of need to be carrying my remote inside and taking it back outside every time. In each of these, you can leave it outside. All right, so now let's move to an outdoor porch, and we'll cut and show you a little picture of it where we don't have a screen. The primary change here is, even if it's fully covered and there's no sun like in this situation and you can't rain on it, you can still get a lot more dust and pollen in. In that case, if you take the chance of putting a regular indoor television out there, you pretty much are gonna have to cover it up during pollen season, and you're gonna wanna cover it up in the winter as well. The Samsung Terrace still works fine in this situation. It handles dust fine and handles water, as well as the Sunbrite and the Seura. You're not gonna have a problem there. So let's move on to partial sun implementations. So in this case, with Samsung, one of the ways they get the 2000 nits, which is the brightest of all these televisions, impacts the way that it handles heat. So they can get this brightness, but it can't handle heat as well. So you have to move up in theirs if you're gonna get full direct sunlight on it to what's called the Samsung full sun version. That's a much more expensive television, but it brings the brightness down to about 1500 nits, and there's actually technology on it that will adjust the brightness depending on how hot it is. If it gets super, super hot, it'll start to bring down the brightness to keep the television cool and thus prolong the life of it. If you don't want to do the Samsung Terrace there, the other options obviously are the Sunbrite, and in this case, it's the Signature 2 version that can handle partial sun and do great out there, and that's about 700 nits, or the Seura, which is also about 700 nits and can also handle. These are a little bit less expensive, so if you're trying to save money off of the Samsung Terrace, those two would be great options as well. Okay, so now let's move to full sun. So you got your pool out there, you go put up a pole, put the television on it, and it's just sitting totally out in the rain. Now what do you do? Well, there's a couple of options. One, the Samsung full sun version will work out there. It does have the brightness, and as you heard, you're gonna drop down to about the 1500 nits and it'll go back and forth. Sunbrite has a version called the Pro 2, and it can handle anything. Spray water all over it, whatever you wanna do. And Seura has a matching one, which is the Ultra Bright version. Both of those run at about 1000 nits. So again, a little bit less light output than what you would find on the Samsung Terrace, but great options. These guys have been in the business for a long, long time, and the televisions will last for a long, long time. Let's get to a few things that no matter what television you choose, you know, what do I need to think about before I do all this? Well, one is electrical. Do you have an electrical outlet where you need to go? And in particular, if we're gonna go put something way out at a pool, we've gotta put probably some lightning protection on it if it's in the southeast or somewhere where there's a lot of lightning happening. And if you start to get into that, I'd encourage you, go use a professional installer who's done this 1000 times. If you're a DIY person and you wanna do this, if you're really technical, go for it. And you can give us a call, we're happy to help you out. But honestly, when you start to get to stuff like this, there's a lot to think about. Wi-Fi, electrical, sound systems, everything else, you're better off going with a pro if you can. Okay, so the next one is the Wi-Fi. The further you get from the house, the more your Wi-Fi signal is going to drop off. Now, you might take your computer outside and go, oh, I've got 20 feet, 30 feet that'll the television can be from the house and I see I've got Wi-Fi. But remember, there's a lot of things that can impact Wi-Fi real time, including how many people are connected to it. If you have a party and you've got 10 people standing between the house and the television is using Wi-Fi, bodies basically suck up Wi-Fi. They're almost the most incredible barrier because there's so much water breaking up that signal. So you're gonna wanna make sure you have great Wi-Fi signal. When AudioVice installs these, we usually go put a dedicated outdoor Wi-Fi access point that covers people's pool area, their grill area, and the televisions and everything else. Okay, so now let's cover sound. So imagine for a second, when you listen in your living room or family room, if you've had a television with no soundbar on it, you've probably been turning it up and up and up, and someone's like, I can't hear it, and then it's too loud. And so the solution usually is, hey, let's go put a soundbar on this so we can all hear it and it, you know, doesn't disturb everyone around us, or let's put a stereo or surround sound system in. Now imagine you take that same thing outside. When you're outside without the walls keeping a contained area to bounce the sound around and keep outdoor sounds out, it's a lot harder. So if you are on a contained screen porch that might have three walls on it or two walls, and it's you're sitting really close to it, you could actually use the television speakers in something like the Samsung Terrace. But in most cases, you are going to wish you had a sound bar. The sound bars, and all three of these have fully waterproof sound bars, bring the sound. So if you got a party, you got 20 people out there or 15 people and you're walking around, everyone can hear it. If you're watching the Super Bowl or you're watching, you know, a golf outing or whatever it is you're watching. The next piece though is there's a lot of people that want great outdoor sound that's not just for the television. And so you come up to things like great outdoor music, whether it's coming from two speakers, so maybe you're playing YouTube or music videos outside, or you want something killer like a landscape system that covers your entire pool area so you can hear whether it's the television playing or you're streaming music to it. we've actually made an entire video and written a review on what are the best options for outdoor music. If you go check that out, you'll hear everything from your speakers on the sides to rock speakers, planter speakers, and then landscape speakers, moving up from the easiest to the best. Go check that out and you'll know everything you need to know about matching your great sound with great outdoor television. Okay, so now let's jump from that to how do I think about actually installing it? And so for most of these applications, people are going to be installing on a brick wall, concrete wall, or something else. And there's a whole bunch of talent around making sure that you can drill into a wall, hold it tightly, not crack your brick and everything else. And again, professional installers know how to do that. So that's been a quick summary of a way to think about outdoor televisions. And again, I would encourage you, if it's in a totally screened in porch, it's not going to get direct sunlight, it's not going to get wet, yes, you can consider indoor television. But remember, you still got to deal with bringing your remote in and out. It'll die a little bit more quickly. That mount itself will start to rust more easily. If you can move up into an outdoor television, it's a much better long-term investment if you can afford it. Then you've got the three major brands. You've got your Samsung, Sunbrite, and you've got your Seura solutions. They're all great solutions. If you've got a great local provider like Audio Advice is here in North Carolina, go to your local provider, ask them what they think about your exact situation, and I'm sure they'll be able to help you out. If you've got more questions or anything home audio related, smart home related, or home theater, check us out at audioadvice.com or stop by one of our award-winning showrooms in North Carolina. And we really appreciate you watching. If you want to learn more, we've got playlists on YouTube on everything from home theater to audio to smart homes. You can go check out and get the latest content we come out with it. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.